look, chill chick, I got a lot of life in my mind. Light skin and dark skin, you mess me like a side. Coming with a banger, it ain't summer, but it's hot kids. I just have to drop it cause I wanna start a block.
Just a spectacular afternoon for football here in the Tar Heel State of North Carolina as EA Sports welcomes you inside Bank of America Stadium in Uptown Charlotte. Just a moment ago, the lights, the cameras, the action, all the pyrotechnics. Everything was ablaze. Everything was allowed here in Bank of America Stadium as Carolina emerged from their tunnel. And we are ready to go as the Panthers get set to match up with the Atlanta Falcons. Taken in at the 3. And he'll be stopped up at the 25. Carry for Christian McCaffrey. A nice little juke. And he's brought down, getting this one up to about the 35.
Well, there's plenty of real estate for him to maneuver on that run. And let's face it, this shouldn't be a surprise. He's one of the better backs in the league. Had to come into this game with the idea, slow him down. Otherwise, it's going to be a long afternoon.
A first carry now for Kareem Hunt. And getting this just shy of midfield, they'll spot it at the 49.
How best to describe that one? I'd say right down Broadway on that run.
A straight ahead running. I think that might be something we see a lot of between the tackles today.
Well, he's enjoying things so far here this afternoon. Sees a crease and bursts through it for a solid game.
Now a man open down the middle of the field. And he goes down, but not before getting this inside the 25.
Probably mean to jump in on you, partner, but they didn't waste any time getting downfield, did they? I mean, a nice big play there.
Three plays, three successful plays in plus territory. Now this defense on its heels a bit.
It seems like they had something targeted there, doesn't it? It's like, okay, we've got a matchup we like coming right out of the gate. Let's go ahead and get right to it.
Here's a throw to his running back. It's complete. Touchdown, Panthers! Christian McCaffrey. His second touchdown on the season. And the Panthers take it right down and score on the opening drive. Gonzalez able to tack on the PAT. And that makes the score 7-0. So look at this. They got the 7-0 lead in the pocket. And they're going to try an onside kick. And a good job here by the Falcons. Their hands team able to recover it. So an onside kick fail in the first quarter. Not sure I completely see the logic there.
It's not apparent, is it? You almost have to go deeper, I think. And maybe if we try and work along with them and speculate a little bit here, they must feel like they need to steal possessions in this game. And maybe they don't match up possession for possession with the opposite team. They've got to steal it and try and gain an advantage. And they tried. They just didn't get it done.
To throw, Huntley. And the catch made by Johnson. And he'll go out of bounds right around the 40. 3 yards the gain there, second down. Well, this defense for the Panthers, they were terrific in the win over Tennessee a week ago.
And what I saw on film was a nearly unstoppable pass rush. 5 sacks last week, plenty of hurries given up. So now what do you do on offense? You just max protect, keep everyone in and run the ball? Or maybe just one or two receiver routes in order to try and keep your quarterback upright?
And he only manages a couple here, down to about the 38-yard line. Just not a whole lot of room to operate there on that carry.
No, not at all. They did a really nice job staying in their proper places and not allowing any lanes to open up.
Huntley to throw. That's into the hands of Pitts, the tight end. And he works it past the 30, almost to the 25.
I think when they look at their offense, they think to themselves, weapons, weapons everywhere, and they want to move the ball around. They want to spread it to different people. But you absolutely know they want to get this man involved as well, and that's what they just did on that play.
A solid run on first down. Gain of 7 leaves him with a 2nd and 3. Pretty effective run there, and now they can start to smell that end zone.
Pound the rock. Make sure you use your O-line to set the tone of dominance and physicality, and pound the rock.
The 2nd down attempt there knocked down as it leaves the quarterback's hand, and it's incomplete.
From the snap, he certainly looked like he knew where he wanted to go with the ball, but surprise, that guy was covered. So that took his attention elsewhere to no avail.
Here's Huntley. That is caught at the 7. And the Falcons are going to have 1st and goal as they try to finish off this drive with 6 points.
A very important 3rd down conversion right there, because when you're trailing and find yourself this deep in enemy territory, the kicker's not even part of your thought process. You got to make it pay off with 6. Nice connection right there to set up 1st and goal.
Flush to his right. And inside the 5 here before he's out of bounds right at the 3. He'll wind up getting right about 4 there on the scramble, and it's 2nd down. Looking to throw, Huntley, and this is caught for a Falcon touchdown. Hayden Hurst, his 1st touchdown on the year. And the Falcons are an extra point away from tying the football game. Koo able to connect on the extra point.
And that will tie our score here in this opening quarter of play.
Each team's had it, each team has scored. 7-7 here as the kick's away. And that'll be a little too hot to handle as it will skip through the end zone for a touchback here. This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. And for them, a touchdown their last go around. Obviously, they'll be hoping to do that again.
And when you start plotting for this drive, when you start thinking to yourself, okay, what are we going to do? You don't go away from what you did before because that worked, but you have to be prepared for wrinkles and counters because you know they'll make some adjustments.
They'll contain him to just 4. 2nd down. From the shotgun to McCaffrey. He fights forward for a couple with a penalty flag down. And the linemen, they're already walking back. So he was holding from that left tackle position.
Everyone tries to keep their hands inside when they're blocking ever since they liberalized the rules where you can extend them out. But sometimes they get out a little wide and they get detected grabbing some cloth.
Forced out to his left. Finding room at the 30. And finally down at the 41-yard line.
As a rookie quarterback, that's exactly how you endear yourself to your teammates. Give it up for the cause. It's also how you end up on the training table, too.
Yeah, it's a catch-22. Coach doesn't like it. Teammates love it. Where do you fall on it?
Well, I fall on wanting to endear yourself to your teammates, but pick your spots. Be smart about it. They need you for the full season.
Yeah, the rookie's going to learn as he goes. So after the run for no gain, here's 2nd and 10. Out of the gun, they run it with Hunt. 4 yards the gain, and it'll bring up a 3rd down.
Some of the most unselfish players on any football team, defensive tackles, because we ask them to just eat up blocks and allow other people to make tackles. But when he can make a play himself, as we just saw there, that's a big day.
5 men in the secondary now for the Falcons on 3rd down. Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football. These two teams all tied after 1. 7-7. And now they're going to go for it. This isn't 4th and...
Let's get activated, let's get activated.
Activated.
Let's get activated, let's get activated.
Go
QB in the pocket, let it go, them bullets penetrate. When you in that field, it get real, just stay dedicated. Go.
Put me in the game, I know what to do.
Show me something.
That's another sack, cause I be running through it. I set up the play, I'ma make a move.
Audible.
Gonna be a blitz if I run into you.
Go. When the kick off the bomb, run it back.
Home.
Hail Mary, pray the feds don't intercept the pack. Familiar with the struggle, look, I'm coming up from scratch.
Nothing.
Huddle with my pain, then I turned it to some racks.
Celebrate.
Nothing motivate me more than when I hear the crowd roar. Chant my name in the stands, I got drums, I got bands. Same ones that was hating, buying tickets, now they fans. Call a blitz, they don't see you, they gonna tackle your little man.
Get them.
Let's get activated.
Just a spectacular afternoon for football here in the Tar Heel State of North Carolina as EA Sports welcomes you inside Bank of America Stadium in Uptown Charlotte. Just a few moments ago, this building was shaking as the Carolina Panthers emerge from the tunnel here in Charlotte. They are ready to go as the Panthers are set to match up with the Atlanta Falcons. And the opening kickoff will not be returned as that will be a touchback. At the 28-yard line. Just a 3-yard gain there. Well, this defense for the Panthers, they were terrific in the win over Tennessee a week ago.
Yeah, and what stood out to me on tape, the way they were flying to the football. So that tells me that they've got all their assignments down and they're playing with extreme confidence.
Now a throw here to his running back. And he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line.
I like it, I like it, I like it. Get everyone involved in the passing game, and you know you can create those great mismatches throwing it to your guys out of the backfield.
And on the first drive, that can also help establish some rhythm, right?
I think so. It gets everyone involved. They feel like they're part of it. It really gets them amped up as they go forward.
On the tackle, it was the West Virginia man, Kaiser White. After the pickup of 5, here's 2nd and 5. And now here's a carry heading left. And he's got Rome. And he is finally going to be brought down, but not before he gets it to the Panthers 30. Plenty of shouts from this crowd as they watch the replay. They want a challenge, and they're going to get one. So an early challenge, and you know that those coaches hate to use those red flags too early, but this one turns out to be successful. And they're going to stop him right at the line of scrimmage. Just no cutback lane to be found whatsoever. 2nd and 10. Now they'll switch it up here and look to throw. Open receiver, that's Hayden Hurst, the tight end. And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25.
Nice job, nice patience right there. Put him on the right side, let him work his way across, put the ball in his hands, and let him work his way upfield with a catch.
On first down, Huntley. Again, that's Hurst. And able to break one tackle, but then quickly brought down. But a nice little game. Give him 9 there on the first down completion. That's a staple of this offense. Drag route to the tight end.
Yeah, he's unable to use his size to break off much more yardage after the catch, but still an effective gain nonetheless.
And he's got his man in stride, complete. And the Falcons are going to be looking at 1st and goal as they move this down to the 4-yard line.
His passing's been on point on this drive, hasn't it? Been very accurate, gotten the ball downfield, gained nice chunks of yardage. But now, in this situation, the field is really condensed, partner. So if he's going to throw the football, that would be pinned.
And that will be taken in by Ridley for a Falcon touchdown. Calvin Ridley, his 2nd touchdown on the season. And the Falcons take it all the way down the field and score on the opening drive. Extra point by Koo, up and good. And it's now a 7-0 game. Following the touchdown, here's Koo to kick off. This is going to be returned from middle of the end zone. And he's going to be taken down inside the 10 at about the 8-yard line.
Anytime you field a kickoff inside your own end zone, you've got to be decisive about whether you're bringing it out or not. Sometimes that indecision can really cost you. That may have been what happened on that play.
They'll come out throwing here on first down. Escaping the pressure right. Oh, he's going to take a shot right away. It got his man complete. And he'll get this one way up just shy of the 45-yard line. A big play that time through the air. 36 yards. Just like that, out of danger and up past the 40 now for first and 10. First carry of the game for Christian McCaffrey. And oh, his first carry, he loses the football. And the Falcons grab it. And they'll start with great field position at the 41-yard line. Now a handoff here to his running back. He'll get it to the 40. Sweet little move in there, but couldn't get much yardage out of it. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's second and 9. Looking to throw on second down. Huntley, and his throw's going to be incomplete.
Quarterbacks work all the time on manipulating a defense with their eyes and their head movement. In this case, he just stared the receiver down. That allowed for excellent coverage, able to knock that one away.
Got a man, and he hits him in stride. And he's going to be stopped here a few yards short of the first as the tackle is made at the 33. That'll give him 8 that time, and that's going to make it fourth down. Off the bootleg, Huntley. That's to his running back, complete. And inside the 20 before he's brought down. Boy, that's some kind of effort. When he caught it, I doubted if he could get there. Knew it was going to be close, but credit him. Really good effort.
How about the rack on that play, the run after catch? But most of the time we think of it as just being an open field and picking up yardage. Sometimes you have to be real physical in order to gain the yardage you need for a first down.
Again, he'll drop to throw. Now he'll dump it underneath to his running back, complete. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8-yard gain, second and 2. From the gun, he'll hand this off. And he stopped immediately there. No gain on the play, and now they're faced with a 3rd and 1. After 1, 7-0 on EA Sports. And he'll give it here to his running back. And he won't have the touchdown, but he will have the first down as he's tackled at the 2. 48 yards now on the ground on just 7 carries. They'll try and run for it on 1st and goal. And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. That's going to go as a loss of 4, and it'll be 2nd down.
I know defensive coordinator is going to be pretty excited about what he just saw there. Great knockback by their front. And now with the ball where it is, I would expect to see the offense throw the ball on 2nd and 3rd down here.
Caught on the slant. Touchdown, Falcons. Kyle Pitts, his 3rd touchdown now on the year. And the Falcons push further out in front. Aku able to connect on the extra point, and it's now 14-0. Following the touchdown, here's Koo to kick off. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And last time, not only the turnover, but that turned into 6 points. They got to make up for that here.
We always hear about empty possessions, but some are worse than others. You can have an empty possession, punt the ball away, get yourself set to play defense, but when you turn it over, it changes momentum, and when they take it downfield and punch it in on you, that's a bad possession all the way around.
Yeah, but you're hungry to get back out there, aren't you?
You better be, because otherwise, it's going to be a long day for you. We use the word relentless a lot with guys who are aggressive on the field. In this case, it really fits, doesn't it? How about his ability to break tackles and his feet never stop moving?
And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8, 2nd and 2.
Good yardage there on first down, exactly what you want. Get yourself set up to keep making first downs, keep the clock running. And if they're smart, you're starting to milk the clock. No hurry before you run your second down play.
Throw left side, McCaffrey's got it. And he's out of bounds as he gets this down to the 45. From Falcon territory now, here's 1st and 10 at the 45-yard line. The play action fake, they'll look to throw. He'll buy some time right. And he'll throw this one away. I don't think he's out of the pocket, no. Here comes the flag. Clearly wasn't outside of the tackle box. There's your penalty.
And accompanying that penalty, a loss of down.
They lose the yardage, and of course, they also lose the down on the grounding call, and it's quickly 2nd and long. They'll set up a throw. Eluding the pressure right. Throwing left side here, and it's complete. So 5 yards here, 5 on the play. And they're going to face an uphill battle here on 3rd and long. They'll set up to throw. Being chased out left. They'll get this to McCaffrey out of the backfield. And he'll get it inside the 40 to the 39. He'll get 17 back there, but it'll still lead to a 4th down. Back to throw again. Dancing to his left. Throwing left side, it's complete. And he'll go out of bounds inside the 15-yard line. From the 13 now, they work on 1st and 10. Shotgun handoff now to McCaffrey. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. Call it no gain on the play, and it'll be 2nd down. Now he'll look to throw here on 2nd and 10. And oh, it'll be intercepted. Snags it for the pick, and the Falcons are going to take possession here. It's a touchback, and they'll take over at the 20-yard line. A reminder, once we hit halftime, as we do all season, we'll send it down to Jonathan Coachman in Orlando. He'll have all the stats and scores from games in progress around the NFL.
The best multitasker in the business, the coach.
Now here's a pass on 1st down that's knocked away and incomplete.
That was well played, but that was also an example of a corner who understands his coverage, realized he had support behind him, and could be a little more aggressive in the shorter zone, and did exactly that, knocking that pass away.
Huntley's throw is on target to Duvernay. And he'll get this up to the 34-yard line. Now the Falcons going to use one of their timeouts, as he'll get a chance to talk it over after picking up the 1st down. Operating from the gun, Huntley. Right back to Duvernay, that's complete. And he'll be out of bounds up near the 45 at the 44.
I do have to admit, I like it when it all comes together. When the top part catching the football, right? Whether you're catching it with your hands or cradling it, comes together with the legs, in this case, the feet.
Into heavy traffic, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Nasir Adderley, and the Panthers will have the football as this is taken up past the 30. He's certainly not been afraid to take some chances downfield. Now look, it's paid off for him a couple of times. That time, not so fortunate.
And that's where I want to start, what you said. It's paid off a couple of times. So his
pressure brought in, and the Falcons get there for the sack. It'll be a loss of five there as the safety blitz winds up paying off. Behind the sticks here with a second and 15. They'll look to throw here. And that falls to the ground incomplete. A nice job of bodying him up defensively. And now it brings up third down. An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Back to throw. Yeah, this pass broken up. Excellent coverage there on third down, as that was not an easy one to hold on to.
That's an excellent job right there on third down. Like any defense, you never want to let them get anything started, and that would have been a first down. Instead, you saw the contact on time, no penalty, and before this drive could get wings, it's fourth down.
They'll try and throw for it here. Rolling to his right. Throw it across his body, and it's intercepted. Picked off by A.J. Terrell. And he will have a first down as they're into field goal range now at the 30. Second interception for him now here in this first half. And you got to think, he's a rookie, Charles. How much does confidence start to become a factor?
I think that's a great question, because that's what they're going to check on when he gets to the sidelines. The coach is going to check on it. His teammates going to check on it. Because when you haven't done it before, it's not something that's part of you. You got to see how you're going to react. Let's see how he bounces back.
Yeah, because two interceptions for him in college and a half. I mean, that just didn't happen. And nothing doing. He's immediately taken down at the line of scrimmage. The chance of wasting this great starting field position. A real threat. This is third and long. Flushed out right. Finding room to the 20. And he'll go out of bounds inside the 15-yard line.
Certainly making his presence felt in both the pass and the run game. He's having an impact.
Yeah, and his first carry of the game right there, he had hurt him with his arm. Now he's showing that he can shuffle the puppies as well. And it's caught. And the Falcons are going to have a first and goal coming up as the tackle made at the 3-yard line. Now a timeout signaled for, and they'll get it with 10 seconds to go before halftime. Here's first and goal, and gosh, points here. A chance maybe to put this thing away before halftime. Touchdown, Kyle Pitts, in the final seconds of the first half. And the Falcons would extend their lead here just before halftime. Extra point by Koo, up and good. And that makes the score 21-0. So 6 seconds, all that remains of this first half as the kick is away. And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully.
The Panthers take over first and 10 at their own 25-yard line.
This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. And only 6 seconds on the clock, so time likely for just one play. He's going to loft one deep over the middle. And that will be incomplete. Would have been a big hitter if they had connected. Instead, it's second down. So we have reached halftime now with the visiting Falcons out on top. As we'll get you down the coast to Orlando for Jonathan Coachman and our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach! All right, Coach, thanks very much. Fine work as always as we welcome you back for quarter number three. The Panthers going to get the football first, trailing here as well as we resume play in this second half. And we will not have a run back here as the second half starts with a touchback. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And that first half, one to forget really on both sides of the ball. They got to find some way to string something together here, don't they?
Yeah, they're down big right now. So as you mentioned, trying to find something to string together, get some consistency, something sustained, maybe calm their whole team down and find a way to get back in this one.
Yeah, because right now you're down. The ball comes out, and this is going to get out of bounds. So they will gain a bit of yardage on the play, actually, and they'll hold on to the football as well. Offensively, they're just not playing a very clean football game right now. This deficit, there's a fumble. Good news for them, at least, that went out of bounds.
You're exactly right. And as they breathe a sigh of relief, you know they're looking at the scoreboard, thinking to themselves, if we turn it over there, things could really...
And now hold everything here as the challenge flag is out, and we're going to get a review of that last play. And we'll get a moment here as they look this one over.
Yeah, remember now, the call on the field is what they'll stick with unless they have clear video evidence to the contrary. And I give these officials a lot of credit. Such a tough and demanding job. You and I both know that. Yeah, they make the right call way more often than they get it wrong.
The first down run got five. Here's second and five. Running with Hunt here out of the shotgun. And he's going to be met at the line of scrimmage and taken down. No gain on the play that time, and they'll look to convert on what will be a third and four. On play action, they'll throw. Swings this out for Hunt. And he is going to have a Panthers first down as they're able to get the third down conversion. Still in search of their first touchdown of the game, but they're on the move. First and 10. Oh, he tried to pitch it, and the ball's loose. We talk a lot about setting the tone to start the game. Well, you want to start the tone right in the third quarter as well, and nearly lost a football there in their first drive.
And sometimes we overdo it when we talk about halftime adjustments and what teams are going to do. Most of the time, it's just a matter of executing the game plan you brought in. But I'll guarantee you, they didn't draw that play up on the whiteboard at halftime. They're fortunate to retain possession.
Flush to his right. Going to throw deep for the end zone. And this is going to be intercepted. Picked off by the Pro Bowler, Marcus Peters. And the Falcons are going to get the football here as the ball will come out to the 20. So it was a drive that had real promise here to begin the third quarter, but ultimately derailed by the INT.
And that was the position you wanted to be in, coming out to start this third quarter, get a nice drive going, looking for the end zone. Possibly got a little bit too greedy right there.
51 yards rushing for him now in the ball game.
Well, no matter how they phrase it, staying on schedule, staying ahead of the sticks, whatever you want to call it, 7 yards on first down, that fits the bill.
And here's a handoff out of the gun. And they'll take him down at the 31-yard line.
Well, you certainly have to give a little credit here because they're playing this game now at their pace. This is ball control football, sustained runs, taking their time, and making it work.
Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. From the gun, they'll try to run it. And he'll scratch out only about a yard up to the 32.
Well, sometimes you just have to give credit to the defense. Great job there at the point of attack, holding up. They won their battles at the line of scrimmage, left him no space to try and run. Really nice job swarming to the ball carrier.
And they'll run on the inside handoff. Not much there, maybe a couple up to the 35. But not much on that run, Charles.
No, that's exactly the way to execute a run blitz there. They guessed correctly that they would move the ball on the ground, honed in on it, and stopped them. Mark that down for a win in the defense's column.
It's C.J. Henderson picking it off. And he will bring this one back. It's a pick six for a Panther touchdown.
It goes without saying, but I'm going to say it anyway. That's a ball he would like to have back, and it lands right in the lap of the defender from there. He doesn't have very far to go before he gets to the end zone, and he got there in a hurry.
Zane Gonzalez on for the extra point. Oh, they flip it to the kicker. He looks like he's going to throw it. And his pass is caught. And this play is not going to work. He's out of bounds, well shy of the goal line. And the try for two, unsuccessful. And they decide fairly early here they need the ball back. So here's an onside kick. And they got it. They recovered it. But hang on now, though. There's a penalty flag down. So they touched it before it went 10, and that's obviously not going to help their comeback bid here in the fourth.
No, not at all. And they're trying to get something going after one there. But you've got to give yourself a chance. Let it go 10 before you touch it.
Now a handoff as they run left side. And he'll work this forward for about three. It's second down.
Partner, you know I love to point out when teams break tendency and do something a little bit different from the norm. But when you run the ball in the first play of the drive, that's not a tendency breaker at all. That's just trying to establish yourself as you move forward.
That is knocked away and incomplete, but a penalty flag. In the backfield, this might be a roughing call. After the penalty, a fresh set of downs. It's first and 10. And they give this time to the tailback. And inside the 20 before he's brought down.
Most of their damage has been done through the air. I mean, they've rung the bell three times with passing touchdowns. But guess what? Ground game has not been neglected. Nice little burst right there.
And they'll try the jet sweep here. Now after the running play, we've got a man down on the field. While the training staff takes a peek, we'll take a break. Hands it off out of the gun. And this won't be enough to pick up the first. A gain of two, third and one. This defense against the run, by the way, they're not top five, but they are top 10.
So what's your philosophy here? Do you try and run the ball against a team that's pretty good against the run? What if you're a pretty good running team? If so, you might want to go ahead and run it anyway because that's your strength.
And the Falcons are going to have a first and goal coming up as they find a way to convert there on third and one. They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And he is met quickly in the backfield. Down he goes, folded like a lawn chair. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down. And that is going to do it for this third quarter of action. You are watching the NFL on EA Sports. Now the Panthers going to use the first of their timeouts. That'll leave them with two remaining. We'll be back after this. Second and goal, and they will try again from the 2-yard line. Off the bootleg, Huntley. They'll roll him out right. And it's intercepted at the goal line. Picked off by J.C. Horn. It's a foot race. He's at the 40. 20. And he will bring this one back. It's a pick six at the touchdown. Well, don't change that channel just yet. This one may have gotten a bit more interesting.
Put down the remote, put down the clicker. This one looked like it was over. It looked like they were ready to seal the deal. But in doing so, by pitching it around a little bit, It cost him. We could have a great finish.
So a big play coming for the Panthers. They'll go for two. They'll look to throw. Steps away. And he will not throw it away. He goes out of bounds, well shy of the line of scrimmage, so that's a sack. Two scores down, two timeouts at their disposal. This is a critical onside kick. And a good job here by the Falcons. Their hands team able to recover it. The fourth quarter, they felt like they needed the football back. Unfortunately, they couldn't get it.
And I know we've brought analytics into the game, and someone has said here that the data says that when a team's expecting an onside kick, 80% of the time, the team expecting it, they do actually recover the ball, which is what we saw here. I just wonder if that number is much more of an anecdotal type of a number, kind of like when the coaches tell us, well, when you score on special teams, 93% of the time you win the game. I'm still waiting to see that number is empirical.
5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and five.
Oh, that's one to warm the hearts of all those old school football players, isn't it? Tough, hard, gritty run. Got behind his pads, bowled over a few people. Look at that one, right up the gut.
So up through three quarters, no reason to lighten up now. And this time not quite to the 30. It'll be down at the 31-yard line. 94 yards rushing for him now as he has been tremendous all day long. So signs of life in what's been a dormant offense in this second half. Here's first and 10. From the gun, he'll hand this off. And he will lose yardage here to the 31-yard line. Officially, it's a 1 yard loss. That's going to bring up second and 11. Now a handoff looking right. They do get a yard there, but only a yard. Leaves them with third and 9 looming.
Brandon, I've got to think this offensive line has got some smiles on its faces. And I know it sounds crazy, but they practiced for this back in training camp. They knew they'd be in situations where it'd be extra defenders in the box coming after them, trying to keep them from locking down a game. Right now, they want to show the world they're up to the challenge.
And inside the 20 before he's brought down. So that was a very nice play, Charles, from a very speedy cornerback.
And that is a situation where in a defender's mind, you just have to pick a point on the football field and think to yourself, I'm going to sprint full out and meet him at that point. Sometimes it works, sometimes it doesn't, but he had to play diagnosed perfectly there.
And the final number here in terms of top speed, I mean, that almost looks like a misprint. He was just absolutely flying, unbelievable. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. A yard in the wrong direction makes third down tougher. Third down and 9. Back to throw. Huntley. Finding his safety valve here. That's complete. And he'll be brought down shy of the first down marker at the 11. Now the Panthers going to signal for their third and final timeout. So that will leave them with no timeouts left. Still plenty of time on the clock. We'll see how that affects things here in this fourth quarter. And his kick here is good. And that will give them a 12-point lead. So that maybe not a knockout blow, but I suppose certainly every little bit helps when you're trying to salt one away in the fourth.
Well, the possibility of being beaten by two late touchdowns or at least sent to overtime does exist. But time, definitely a big factor at this stage of the game, is in their favor.
This Carolina offense at the line, ready to go. And 3 interceptions in this game. And I would have to think, I wasn't a quarterback, but number 4 is kind of, oh, you're like, oh, man, I can't throw 4.
No, and what's interesting is, what do the coaches decide to do now? Having thrown 3, do you alter your offensive strategy? Do you take the ball out of his hands and maybe turn to the running game? Or do you have that supreme confidence that he's going to turn things around?
We'll see what they do. He'll try again with the arm here on second down. Gets this to his running back. It's Christian McCaffrey. And from the 25, they work this to the 29, a gain of 4. On third down, he'll drop to throw. Steps away to his left. Toward the sideline. Did he keep the feet in? Yes, he got them both down, says the side judge. And that's good enough for a first down. Clock management, definitely critical here if they want to get back in this game.
Absolutely agree. They have to up the tempo in this case, down a couple of scores. Want to make sure they have a chance to win this ball game.
And that one drops down, incomplete. Good coverage there, forced the ball free, and it's second down. They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. Toward the sideline, and look at that catch. Dragging the toes, and that's going to be a first down. Well done. A big connection on that one. 32 yards. So a big play as it gets him all the way down to the 20 now for first and 10. Inside the red zone here. They'll look to throw. And it'll be caught in the end zone for the Carolina touchdown by DJ Moore. DJ Moore, his fourth touchdown on the year. And the Panthers have made it a one-score game again here in the fourth. And now remember, all touchdowns are reviewed, and in a tight game like this, they're going to take a good long look at it. All right, now a big two-point conversion attempt still to come. They'll try and throw for it. Incomplete.
I don't know about you, but I can't wait for a few years of two-point tries and see what the data tells us, because a lot of teams want to throw the ball in this situation, this time unsuccessfully. I just wonder if maybe running the ball might be the way to go.
With it moved up from the three to the two, you would think maybe a few more attempts at running.
I think stats over time may bear out that running the ball will at least be the equal of throwing it in that situation.
And trouble there on the kickoff as that goes out of bounds.
And that drives coaches insane, doesn't it? When they see that happen, it just doesn't feel right, does it? Plus, you're giving up yardage.
Good starting field position for them as they come up first and 10 at the 40. And here's a handoff out of the gun. Credit him with a one-yard gain there to make it second and 9. Fourth quarter, down to the final 2 minutes, and we've got a one-score game. So it's Falcon football as we welcome you back. They've got a second down now as they search for a way to get this one to the finish line. And he'll be taken down just shy of midfield.
104 yards on the ground for him so far.
And this is an absolutely big third down that's been set up here, partner. And there's no other way to put it. The defense has to get a stop here to have any hopes of winning this game.
Pastor, you said big third down. I'd put the word big in capital letters here. Touchdown, Falcons! A big play there. His fourth touchdown on the year. And the Falcons are looking to make it two straight as they add on to this fourth quarter lead. Koo now for the point after. And the lead is now 13. Following the touchdown, here's Koo to kick off. And that one will bounce out of the back of the end zone, so we will start here at the 25. The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. And that last drive, a long drive, but not just that, they had a great air attack going. Do they stick with that?
I would think that they would, because if they were confident enough to do it on the last drive, starting backed up in their own territory, why would you change anything? They've got to be confident about what they're presenting and continue to do so.
Yeah, because the secondary, they really look clueless.
And that was amazing, because that drive went and went, no adjustments and no big plays by the defense to knock the ball away.
And he'll be out of bounds across the 30-yard line. They get 6. That'll leave them with 3rd and 4. Check Michael Adams. They're going to look to throw. Buying time to his left. And he gets this up across the 35 before he's out of bounds. Late in the game, defense trying to avoid a big play. He's able to work out of the passing game, turn it into a run, pick up the first, and stop the clock as well.
And you know, in this situation, everything is sped up. The intensity, the thinking, everyone's movement. But for a quarterback, he has to continue to be what we call a flatliner. Level in everything he does and read the clock, feel it in the pocket, and go at the appropriate time.
And he'll be out of bounds just shy of the 40. Working the sideline there. Good route, good catch. First down, and he gets out of bounds.
They have to like the play call because you have to run some guys down the middle of the field to draw some of the defenders away. They can't just let them guard the sideline exclusively. That's how it's going to work. Sidelines and incompletions to use the clock.
Now this one complete downfield on the left side. And down to the 20 he'll go before heading out of bounds. Defensively here, you've got the cushion, but back-to-back pretty big pass plays there. Bend but don't break, but are they bending too much?
I think that they are. To me, it'd be like playing basketball, and you put up a token press. Make sure you get up there and make them eat up some time. Make it a little bit of resistance so they can't just run it right down your throat.
Throwing on first down, but this one winds up to be incomplete.
Whew, that's certainly not the worst thing. It stops the clock and lets your offense catch its breath and lets us exhale a little bit. Now I expect them to call a couple plays in the huddle.
And this is intercepted, and that should do it. And the ball is knocked out. So they escape, so to speak, maintaining the football. Defensively, though, opportunity miss.
It definitely was, because that's all defenses talk about. Getting the football and either advancing it the other way or just getting possession and turning it over to their offense. That can be a little bit deflating. You're exactly right. A lost opportunity.
A real field flipper there as all of a sudden they've got a first down in the red zone. He'll drop to throw. On the move to his left. And he'll dump this off to his running back, McCaffrey. And he's tackled a yard short of the marker. Good gain of 9 on first down. Second and 1. Escaping the pressure right. Nowhere to go here. He lost the football. Fortunate to get that football back because trailing here in the second half, last thing they needed was to lose the possession.
And the word I think of here is opportunity, because it could have been lost there, their chance to score points. But the opportunity for the defense was to go ahead and really close this game down if they were able to get possession.
And he's able to pick up the first before he's brought down inside the 5 at the 4. So time runs out. It's a victory for the Atlanta Falcons. And you've got to say, CD, it was the defense who had a big part in the W.
Well, without question. When you force 4 turnovers, you get to enjoy the spoils of victory, don't you? It's rare that you force 4 turnovers and lose a ball game. That's almost unheard of. They carried this one home. He talked about celebrating with each other and being in a position where going forward, all you think about is, let's get 5 next time. They're going to be on the hunt.
So for Atlanta, they move back over 500 at 3-2 now on the year. And they will head home next week to take on...
Music. They want me to count to y'all, but ain't gon' count to y'all, cause y'all went there when they ain't had a ball. He talk his booty, wonder how he felt watching his dog casket fall. I had to tell my YG stop, he don't like to pass the ball. That chicken, he talking thick hit, I was kicking in houses for it. That's 2 different tickets, right? Oh yeah, they loud, boy. Them players lazy, they don't get no bread. Yeah, they be counting, boy. Them labels scouting, boy. They talking M's only the 1,000, boy. I had to get 2 touch, and they get 2 foul, boy. I'm talking